It is finally here, the standard range Tesla Model Y. A lot of people didn't know if this was going to become a thing or not. I thought it was actually dead because Elon had tweeted earlier this year that they were going to kill off any Tesla that wasn't at least 250 miles of range. And this standard range Tesla Model Y, even though it is the cheapest Model Y ever made, it does have less than 250 miles of range, and it has a few other interesting quirks and facts about it. So let's go over the standard range Tesla Model Y real quick and see if it is a good buy and see how it stacks up to the Model 3 and the current Model Y options, and then also the competitors that are coming out that are already out as well. So the standard range Model Y comes in at $42,000, and it's about $8,000 less than the long range dual motor all-wheel drive Model Y. And the standard range Model Y is only a rear wheel drive, so it only has one motor in the back compared to the dual motor all-wheel drive long range Model Y. And there are some benefits of having just one motor. I am a long range rear wheel drive Model 3 owner. You get better efficiency. So this Model Y, the standard range rear wheel drive, is going to be the best, the most energy efficient Model Y out of all the Model Y models. So that is a good thing about this. However, let's look at these specs. The standard range rear wheel drive Model Y has a range of 244 miles on a full charge and can go 0 to 60 in 5.3 seconds. So it's kind of confusing, but understandable in a way that Tesla has decided to produce this standard range Model Y and deliver it in 2 to 5 weeks, it says. So you can probably get it pretty quickly if you want to order it. But a lot of people, including myself, are waiting on the long range rear wheel drive Model Y, which Tesla had promised that they were going to come out with this year. It still could be a possibility. However, with this standard range Model Y coming out, it seems like it's further on down the line, or maybe not even going to come. So right now, if you want a rear wheel drive, you're going to have to settle with the standard range, so a little bit less range. Now, the good thing about having a standard range Model Y instead of a long range rear wheel drive Model Y is that, of course, it's cheaper, which is good because this is going to compete really well with the Ford Mach-E, which I've been hearing really good things about. So that is a contender, and I think Tesla had that in mind when they were pricing this Model Y and decided to come out with the standard range Model Y, because the standard range Model Y is coming in at just under $42,000, which undercuts the standard model of the Ford Mach-E. The Ford Mach-E still has the eligibility for the $7,500 federal tax incentive, which Tesla does not have. And this is also good because if you compare this to the Model 3 Standard Range Plus, even though the Standard Range Plus Model 3 has about 20 more miles of range and it's about $4,000 cheaper, you're getting a lot more storage with the Model Y. And the thing to note about this is the Standard Range Model Y comes with premium interior, which the Model 3 Standard Range Plus only comes with partial premium interior, which is interesting. So if you're looking for the cheapest Tesla and you still want that premium interior with the high quality sound system, the Standard Range Model Y might be your best pick now, because it's only $4,000 more expensive than the Model 3 Standard Range Plus, which has the partial premium and you don't get that high quality sound system. And you also get way more storage room with the Model Y. And speaking of storage room, Tesla also released the 7-seater Model Y, which a lot of people have been waiting for. This is going to be very interesting because there are no pictures online on the Model Y configurator for the 7-seater. We don't really know what it looks like, so hopefully somebody will take delivery in the next 2 to 5 weeks and we'll see what that 7-seater looks like, because a lot of people are saying, and including myself, the two seats in the very back are going to be very tight. They're going to be very small, and I'm not sure if a full-grown adult, two full-grown adults at that, are going to be able to fit back there, but we will find out. And if you're a lucky owner of a 7-seater Model Y near Louisville, Kentucky, hit me up. I will be glad to check it out and make a video about that. So the 7-seat option is $3,000, and you can add that to any Model Y except the Performance Model Y, which is interesting. 7-seat interior includes third row seating for two, easy entry into third row, third row USB-C charging, sliding second row with adjustable seat backs, fold flat second and third rows for maximum cargo storage, and electronic fold flat releases and trunk. A lot of people come to me and say, Andy, what should I get, a Model 3 or a Model Y or a non-Tesla? Well, it's hard for me to recommend a non-Tesla just because the vast supercharger network that Tesla has. So if you're planning to do road trips in your electric vehicle, it's almost a necessity to get a Tesla, because that supercharger network will be your lifesaver on a road trip. So if you are comparing Model 3 to Model Y and trying to figure out which one would be best for you, do you want more storage or do you want more of a sportier ride with the Model 3? So Model Y is going to give you a lot more storage. It's got the hatchback with the folding seats. But recently, Tesla has made the choice a little bit harder because the Model 3 now comes with power trunk. So even though it doesn't have that hatchback, it's a power liftgate just like with the Model Y. So those are both very similar in the way that they operate. They're both automatic now. And then, of course, the Model 3 has that new refresh, which the Model Y should be getting very soon. We don't know when that is going to be coming in the US. But if you want the most energy efficient, I always recommend going with the long-range Model 3 non-performance, because that's going to have up to 350 miles of range, which is awesome. However, it's going to be interesting to see what this new standard range Model Y, the energy efficiency that it gets, because it's going to be a little bit more efficient than the long range. It should be, at least. We'll find out. I could be wrong about that. But I know with my long range rear wheel drive Model 3, I get about 245 watt hours per mile, lifetime average over 70,000 miles. So it's been very energy efficient just because it has that single motor. We'll see what the standard range Model Y energy efficiency is with just that single motor compared to the two. But at the end of the day, I consider the Model Y being the best overall electric car just because it has a lot of storage room. It's future proof in case you're going to have a family in the future, or you need just more room for passengers or cargo in the future and you want to keep it a long time. It might be a little bit more future proof than the Model 3. And then, of course, you know, with the standard range Model Y, you're getting a great vehicle for just over $40,000, and you're getting that premium interior, which doesn't come in the standard range plus Model 3. So if you don't need the all-wheel drive dual motor benefits of the long range Model Y, then the standard range Model Y could be a great, fantastic vehicle for you if you're looking to get a Tesla. So those are my first impressions and thoughts of hearing about the standard range Model Y. I was really hoping for a long range rear wheel drive Model Y. If that would have came out, I may have bought it, and we'll see. I may still buy one. We'll look at the standard range. I really hesitate to buy something that has less than 300 miles of range. I plan to make a whole video about that in the future. If you want to stick around, subscribe, because I have a lot of thoughts on the 300 mile minimum. If you want to see more Tesla and tech videos in the future, make sure you subscribe. Hit that like button if you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching. My name is Andy. I'll talk to you in the next one.